Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Jives Fishing. So today we are finally back at Punggol Waterfront. Yep, so time now is about 8-9 o'clock. Yeah, we had some footage from another day, day session, which we will probably combine to today lah. Yeah, because we didn't get anything else on that day. Yeah, so we'll roll the footage. Should be after this video lah. We'll roll that footage. Yeah, so that you all can just enjoy it. So anyway, today we'll be fishing rising then lowering tide. Yeah. So I don't know how long we'll stay. Maybe 6 hours. I don't know. See how things go. Okay, bait for today is kelong sotong. Yep. So hopefully we get something. And we'll update you guys again later.
Wow, go fire.
It's a female, there's no cloaca here. Yeah, males have the two things that are called cloaca. Of course, again, be careful of the rub down here, don't let it step you. So anyway, go release this one, it's really small. Okay, bye bye.
It's flat also.
Yeah. Thank you.
Put out some small hooks, hopefully can catch some bait. Yeah, but not sure if there's anything on. Hopefully there is. Is there? Oh yes! Gelama, good bait. Time for a bait. Yes! Bend in the rod.
Oh, Bari.
Bari. Nice Bari.
Yeah.
Don't swing up. I think yeah.
Can
I? Yeah, okay. Look at the rod. Okay. Yeah, nice Bari. Oh, this one is a male.
Vespers. Okay, be careful, be careful.
Okay,
the pirates. Okay. Oh, white spotted.
Huh? White I thought blue spotted.
Oh, blue spotted, blue sorry. Spotted. Yeah.
Bye bye.
Whoa.
Some
that?
Starfish. Oh,
crab.
Oh.
Yep. Decent size crab.
Hey guys, so the total CR for now is 2 stingray. Yeah, we had one in the morning. Yeah, but I didn't film my intro before that lah, so too bad.
Afternoon.
Yeah, afternoon actually, not morning. Like last light, close to last light. Yeah, but I didn't film my intro then, so too bad lah. We'll just work in that footage. And we had one blue spotted stingray after that. Yeah. So other than that, it's been quite quiet. There's been a lot of crabs and small fish nibbling at our bait. Yeah. So we'll keep fishing. The time now is about 9 plus. Yeah, I'm getting a bit tired actually. But yeah, never mind lah. So we'll see how things go. Update you guys again later.
Okay, so this is what you should do in the event that you are poked by a venomous anything lah, okay. Short of those that you know are fatal, like stonefish or that. Yeah, so if you are poked by a usat or tosat, those catfish, right? So the best thing you can do is maybe like pour some hot water on it to stop or slow down the venom. Yeah, then after that, you just have to leave it all. Then it'll hurt maybe for a few hours, and then after that, it should go away. It should. If it doesn't go away, then you probably need to see a doctor. Maybe there's some part of the spine that is still inside. Yeah, and you will get infected. So if maybe after like one day the pain is still there, it doesn't go away, then you should consider seeing a doctor. Yeah, so how this happened was quite stupid. Okay, I used pliers this time, but when I was shaking the fish off the hook, it flew off and it landed on my arm. Yeah, it's a very stupid accident. Yeah, so basically the spine landed on my arm lah. So it went through my sleeve and then into my hand. Yeah, so you can see the place where it went in lah. Yeah, it was bleeding just now. Now it's pretty okay. And if there's venom, you will notice this clear liquid that is coming out of your wound lah. So you know that that fish or what has venom inside, and the venom, some of it has gotten into your body. Yeah, so of course it will hurt, and it will hurt more than any normal cut or something lah. So that's how you know whether it's venomous or not. Yeah, in case you like you don't know what poked you. Yeah, so anyway, hopefully it gets better after a while. Yep, so we'll update you guys again later.
Take like that one. The take really like fish. And now it's a crab. Wow. You want it? If you want. Well.
Tighten a bit though.
sun.
Bit of sun.
Send the food back.
Bro. Tosa just now was like...
It was 10 times his size.
No, oh, want to do something. Quite a noisy deck. Maybe because the rod light. Maybe a Usa Duri. Yeah. Oh. What is it? Hey, Balor. Eh, Kaji. Is it? Eh?
Is it a small...
Gelama? Is it a Gelama? It got archer fish.
Yeah. Small Gelama.
Gelama. Oh, that's quite interesting. That kind of size, the Gelama. Not bad. That is interesting. Long Gelama. You want to eat this? Don't want. Then put back. Come go. Quite nice eh.
Isn't it grow quite big ones?
Oh, but it's soloed.
I don't know.
Hey, so that was a croaker or Gelama. We call Nunama in Chinese, and that was the biggest one we ever caught actually. Yeah, usually we catch them, they are very very small, and we bait them up live, but that one was bigger and it was gahook, so we are not going to eat it, but we kept it to use as bait. Yeah, so you'll probably see in another video, maybe we'll chop it up and use it as bait for surf casting. Yeah, so thing to note, I just found out just now that croaker actually have very sharp teeth. They have two on top and one below. Yeah, so one of them actually went through my finger. Yeah, so just be careful lah. They look very harmless, but they have very sharp teeth. Yep, so anyway, we'll keep fishing. Update you guys again later. Right guys, so we have a handline here and another handline there and two more handlines further down. So we have about four or five handlines. We have our rod here. We are rebaiting currently two more surf cast rods. Yeah, and there's this rod that we hit the Gelama on. And yeah, so oi. Just put it on. Why? Wait, why is this one so loose?
Why is this
white
tail?
Huh?
White
tail. Why ah? Wait. This one so. This one is... Wait, you put it on ah?
Wait,
what? Hey, dude! Oh my! Hey,
what the heck?
Oh, it's some big. Hey, you think it's garbage? It's quite. It's bigger than the previous one. This one got like 1+ kilos. Try out.
Oh, really nice.
Yeah. Is it? How is it hook? Can see? Eh, reflection.
Yeah, it's a reflection.
Okay, bring up. No, oh my god, dude, it's at the side. Hey, no, it's not, dude, it's not.
Yeah.
It's not reflection.
Wait, what?
It's our sinker. It's from the behind. Handline. Dude, he ate both.
How is that possible, though?
I don't know. No, he ate
but
both.
But he never ring first, though.
Maybe he ate that one, then he swim to the side.
one under is a bit sad.
Yeah, they said the other one was loose. Yeah, it looks like this. There's two hooks in his mouth. One inside the... one in the side, one deep inside. And both the lines are very tangled. Yeah, there's two sinkers. Yeah. So it's both our handline there and our handline here. Oh, that one drop I still don't know. I only see the line loose. Okay. Wow, this is a very nice mangrove jack. Oh, chia zong. Oh, the tail a bit scratched up. Ooh. Okay, so that was a mangrove jack or chia zo. Yeah, so it's one of the snappers we have in Singapore la. And we don't see it that often. I think we caught a small, slightly smaller one in the previous episode. Yeah, so this is the biggest one on this channel so far. Yeah, and it's a very beautiful fish, very nice catch. It actually took two of our hand lines, yeah, which I was very surprised by, because I saw one line slack and then the other line was tight, and then we realized that there was actually another sinker hanging from the fish. Yeah, so we actually ate both kelong sotong. Yeah, so snapper, they are quite greedy fish. Yeah, so anyway, we kept that one, cleaned it. Probably gonna bring home and cook it. Yeah, so just a reminder, please keep the waterfront clean. Clean up after yourselves. We are still finding a lot of rigs, a lot of hooks everywhere. Yeah, so anyway, we'll keep fishing and update you guys again later. Okay, so we just brought in our crab net and there is two thunder crabs inside. Not the intended target. Yeah, so this is a female. Yep, and this is... don't grab onto things. Also a female. Yep, they're both females. Yeah, so anyway, it's not our intended target. My manipi hawiki, the thunder crab. So only the claws are edible. We are not going to eat this, so we're just going to let it go. Yeah, but they are very, very strong and really, really be careful not to get pinched by these guys, because their claws can crush your finger. Yeah, so really just be careful. So anyway, we'll get these guys out and yeah, let them go. Okay, so here are the two thunder crabs. Yeah, so anyway, gonna let them go because we don't really have use for them. Yep. Okay, don't pinch me. Bye bye.
Very nice green, nice green. Yeah. It's coming to force. Yeah. We're probably gonna bait it up. Been a while since we iggy already, yeah. So this is our first green eye in quite a while. Very nice. Very nice colours. This one is called Greeneye, I guess, because the eye there is green. Yeah, so usually we just cut the head off, then we cut the body into strips. Yeah, then we bait the head and then also bait the strips. Yeah, okay.
So you put on the
headline. So we put this boot up on the headline. Then guess what is inside? Wait, it's gone.
He went down. He's scared.
Yeah, it was a thunder crab.
Pour the water.
Yeah. There's a crab inside this boot. Really cool stuff.
My sotong still there. Inside.
Yeah. And a brittle star.
Yeah.
It's a crab's home, lah. So
what are we gonna take out the crab? What's this spiky thing?
Oh, it's baby. Eh?
It's soft one, eh?
This
It's soft, eh?
Sponge?
Is it?
Could be a sponge, eh?
Really, eh?
Yeah. So, when we turn the boat over, we realize that there's two of them.
Under crabs.
Yeah, so you see, they immediately go for shelter. It's their nature to hide. Yeah, so.
They are fighting the grass.
Maybe
his wife.
And then, yeah. It's one male, one female, so.
Okay, so here we have the guts of the mangrove jack, the cha zo. Yeah, so we're gonna use it as crab bait. So now the fish is wasted. Yeah, so our crab net, gonna cast this out. Hopefully we get some crabs. Yeah, they've been pulling at our bait for a while, so it's a little bit irritating. Yeah, so hopefully we get some flower crabs. And yeah, I'll update you guys again later. Alright guys, so that's all for this trip. Yeah, there was nothing much after the mangrove snapper. So, two stingray, one croaker. Oh, we lost a big tosat, catfish, eel-tail catfish or sembilang. Yeah, we lost a big one. I think it was like 2+ kilo. Yeah, our line broke when I was trying to bring it up. So, I'm not too sad about that, it's okay. We'll probably let it go anyway, even if we brought it up. Yeah, so it's okay lah, that one is gone. Yeah, anyway, thanks for watching. We'll probably roll the footage from another day after this. Yep, so hope you guys enjoy yourself. Hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye!